白饼聚会跟那个四班线上到这里结束，请英文堂的弟兄姊妹静静的离开。
The breaking of bread meeting ends here, and the English service can go to the back hall.
我们把时间交给戴文森弟兄和吕广安弟兄，谢谢。
And give the rest of time to Brother Davidson. Thank you.
Hallelujah, we serve a risen Savior.
感谢赞美主，我们服侍的是一个复活的救主。
And this morning, we want to consider the risen Savior.
今天早上我们一来看一个复活的救主。
Our scripture reading is taken from Matthew chapter 28.
我们会一同来读马太福音二十八章。
Commencing from verses 1 to 10.
第一到第十节。
After the Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for the angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it.
安息一章近，七的头一。天快亮的时候，莫大拉的玛利亚和那个玛利亚来看坟墓。忽然地大震动，因为有主的使者从天上下来，把石头滚开，坐在上面。
His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women,Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified.
他的相貌如同闪电，衣服洁白如雪。看守的人就因他吓得浑身乱颤，甚至和死人一样。天使对妇女说：不要害怕，我知道你们是寻找那钉十字架的耶稣。
He is not here, he has risen.Just as he said, come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples he has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you would see him. Now I have told you. So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell.His disciples.
他不在这里，照他所说的已经复活了。你们来看，放主的地方。快去告诉他的门徒，说他从死里复活了，并且在你们以前往加利利去，在哪里你们要见他。看啊，我已经告诉你们了。妇女们就急忙离开坟墓，又害怕又大大的欢喜，跑去要报给他们的门徒。
Suddenly Jesus met them. Greetings, he said. They came to him, clasped his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they shall see me.
忽然耶稣遇见他们说，愿你们平安。他们就上前抱住他的脚，拜他。耶稣对他们说：“不要害怕，你们去告诉我的弟兄，叫他们往加利利去，在哪里我必见我。”
Today, the whole of Christendom is celebrating Easter.
今天整个基督教来庆祝复活节。
Easter is a day we Christians celebrate the bodily resurrection.Of our Lord Jesus Christ.
复活节是基督徒庆祝耶稣肉身死亡以后肉身复活了。
The bodily resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ is the cardinal doctrine or teaching of biblical Christianity.
耶稣基督从肉身复活是整个基督教最基要的教义。
It is the foundation of Christianity.
这个是基督教的根基。
Without the bodily resurrection of Jesus Christ, there is no Christianity.
其实，如果基督耶稣没有从肉身复活，根本就没有基督教。
And our faith is in vain.
我们的相信也是徒然的。
Over the centuries, from the time of New Testament till the present time, there have been many people who have been doubting and trying to disprove the facts that Jesus rose from the grave.
但是自从新约以来，那么多的世纪，不断的有人希望把耶稣复活这个事实推翻了。
Various theories and explanations were given to explain away the resurrection of Jesus.
很多人用不同的方法解释，其实耶稣基督根本没有复活。
Because Christianity rises or falls based on this one cardinal truth.
因为基督教能不能成立，就在乎这个复活的事实是真的还是假的。
And that cardinal truth is the fact that Jesus rose from the dead.
这个最重要的根基是什么？就是耶稣已经从死里复活。
If we can successfully adduce evidence to prove that Jesus did not rise from the grave,
其实如果我们能够找到证据证明耶稣根本没有复活。
Then there is no basis for Christianity to exist.
那根本基督教就没有价值基础的存在。
And Christianity is just a hoax.
整个基督教就是谎言。
And this is what some prominent lawyers over the years set out to do.
其实很多年来，有许多很优秀的律师就尝试这样来做。
These lawyers were convinced that Jesus did not rise from the grave and the resurrection is a hoax.
这些优秀的律师，他们自己已经决定了，其实耶稣没有复活，整个基督教都是谎言。
So they spent a lot of time and resources and energy engaging in research.
他们就花很多的时间精力研究研究。看能不能找到。
Gathering evidence and examining evidence.
找到证据，然后要检验那个证据。
Which we call forensic evidence.
就是好像法医一样，去看那个事实是怎么样。
To once and for all nail the story of the resurrection and put it to rest.
希望找到以后就一次过把基督教钉死了。
One such American lawyer was a lawyer by the name of Lewis Wallace.
其中有这个美国的律师很优秀的，他的名字叫 Lewis Wallace.
Wallace set out to write a book disapproving the resurrection of Christ.
他要开始写一本书，把整个耶稣复活的变成一个谎言。
To prove or disprove the truth of a historic event.
但是如果你要证明历史上已经发生的事情呢
？A person must use the same principle used by lawyers to prove or disprove the truth of an event related to a court case.
那你就一定要用法庭的方法来证明或者反证究竟有没有发生这些事情。
So Wallace, being a lawyer, was trained and qualified.To examine the evidence.
Wallace 是一个律师，他的训练就是去看证据能不能成立。
So he examined the writings and behavior of the earliest witnesses of the resurrection of Christ.
他就很仔细地看耶稣基督复活的那个年代信徒的表现，还有他们的著作是怎么样。
And Wallace, after studying the evidence,concluded, contrary to his predisposition, that Jesus Christ indeed rose from the dead and was seen by his disciples.
经过很详细的研究所有的证据的时候，比他本来以为能反对的，他结论就是 基督真的从死里复活。
Wallace then went on to write the famous book called Ben-Hur.
所以基督他就写一个书，就是很著名的那个奔虚。
A tale of Christ and made it into one of Hollywood's most acclaimed movies.
就说明基督的生平，以后荷里胡就把变成一个很著名的电影。
And I'm sure some of you would have seen that movie, Ben-Hur.
我相信大家很多都看过那个奔虚那个很大场面的影片。
Another individual who began as a skeptic and ended up writing a book affirming the resurrection was a British lawyer called Frank Morrison.
另外一个很出名的就叫 Frank Morrison， 是英国的律师。他也是本来是很不相信的，到最后写一本书就证明这个复活的事实。
Although Morrison set out to write a book to disprove the resurrection and call it a hoax and prove that it was a hoax, after seeping through the evidence, he was so convinced that Jesus rose from the grave.
本来他要写一本书要推翻基督教耶稣复活的可能性，但是发觉最后他只能再次确定这个是事实。
And Morrison wrote a book, Who Moved the Stone?
他写了一本书，最后就是说谁把石头滚开。
Simon Greenleaf was one of the founders of Harvard Law School.
另外一个从哈佛法律学院那个叫 Simon Greenleaf.
And he was an expert on the law of evidence.
他是专家，是专门去看证据的专家。
Greenleaf literally wrote the law of evidence for the United States legal system.
其实 Greenleaf 他是负责美国法律上面要找证据来证明事实，法庭用的这个文献。
He was certainly a man who knew how to weigh the facts against evidence.
他很知道怎么样事实跟证据要连在一起。
Greenleaf was an atheist. He did not believe in God.
他根本是一个无神论的，不相信有神。
But he accepted a challenge from his students to investigate the case for Christ's resurrection.
但是有一天，他的学生挑战他，究竟基督复活有可能性吗？
After collecting the evidence very meticulously and studying the evidence, he came to the conclusion that Jesus indeed rose from the grave.
他经过很详细的看去查的时候，最后的结论就是基督真的复活了。
Not only that, Greenleaf became a Christian because he was so convinced after looking at the evidence that Jesus rose from the dead.
最后他继续成为一个基督徒，因为他没有办法拒绝他所找到的证据。
There is a man called Sir Lionel Lacoue.
有一个确系叫 Lionel Lacoue.
He is considered to be the greatest lawyers in British history.
他是英国历史上法律上的最有名的律师。
His name is recorded in the Guinness Book of Records.
他的名字其实在那个吉尼斯那个大世界大全里面有写的。
As the most successful advocate with 245 consecutive murder acquittals.
是全世界最有名的辩护律师。为什么？他有245个本来是谋杀的，他打给他推翻了。
He was knighted twice by Queen Elizabeth II.
他英女王二世两次封他成为确士。
And this is what he had to say.
他说什么呢？
I humbly add, I have spent more than 42 years as a defense trial lawyer.Appearing in many parts of the world and am still in active practice.
很谦卑的我告诉大家，我已经42年当一个辩护律师，在世界许多的国家，我还在这样的做。
I have been fortunate to secure a number of successes in jury trials, and I say unequivocally, the evidence for the resurrection of Christ is so overwhelming that it compels acceptance by proof, which leaves absolutely no proof for doubt.
我很荣幸的能够很成功的辩护很多的个案，但是今天我很毫无记忆地告诉大家，耶稣基督的复活，他的证据是那么的丰富的话，完全能够让我们全人的接受，一点都不应该，不需要怀疑，绝对没有怀疑的地方。
All these learned lawyers set out to disprove and discredit the resurrection of Jesus.
以上所说的很著名很聪明的律师，他们本来开始的时候就是要研究推翻基督教。
But in the process of examining the evidences,
但是在他们的过程里面要找证据的时候，
they came to the conclusion that the resurrection did indeed happen.
最后的结论就是复活真的出现发生了。
They were all non-believers, but after looking through the evidences, they were compelled to believe in the risen Lord.
他们本来都是不相信的，但是经过详细的考察的时候，他们只能结论耶稣基督真的复活，他们就成为基督徒。
Their evidences included not only ancient historical records,but also archaeological evidences.
他们查考什么呢？不但是古时的写下的文献，也包括考古学的证据。
They also examined the evidences of all those who personally saw Jesus after his resurrection.
他们特别去看那些见证人亲眼看过主耶稣复活的，他们的记载是什么？
They also looked at the behavior of these witnesses in their own lives and the impact they made on those who came to know Jesus after their listening to their preaching.
不但是他们所写的，他们也看究竟他们的生活有什么改变，他们影响周围的人是什么的事情。
It is evident from early reliable written historical accounts that the eyewitnesses of the resurrection lived a holy life and died rather than deny their faith.
很多的文献就发觉，那些亲眼看过耶稣复活的人，他们活的生命完全改变过来，他们情愿死为着耶稣。
Of the original apostles, only John lived to an old age.
十二个门徒只有约翰活到很年纪很大。
And even he was severely persecuted.
他也受到很多的逼迫。
All of them lived a radiant life.
但所有这些信徒活到一个很灿烂的生命。
And because of their witness, Christians multiplied in 3 continents.
就是因为他们的见证，整个基督教在3个州都发展得很快。
And the church grew in these 3 continents.
教会就在这些区域里面发展得很快。
Those who encountered Jesus lived a life of radical obedience to him.
真的认识耶稣的人，他们的生命改变，完全的顺服基督。
They died under persecution.And left behind churches that were growing rapidly.
虽然他们被逼迫甚至乎死，但是教会更快的发展。
This alone is strong inferential evidence that their claim to have seen the risen Christ was indeed the truth.
其实这个是一个很强的证明，他们所看见的复活的基督是事实。
The very fact that they have seen the risen Christ was their motivation for them to live and die the way they did.
他们因为看过复活的基督，就足够他们要知道怎么样生活，怎么样为主而活，为主而死。
Jesus, the Bible records, appeared to several people after his resurrection.
其实圣经告诉我们，耶稣复活以后，显明显现给一批的人。
He appeared to Mary Magdalene and the other two ladies with her.
首先，莫大拉的玛利亚，还有两个的妇女。
He appeared to two men on the road to Emmaus.
还有往以马忤西路上的两个门徒。
He appeared to the apostles with Thomas present.
还有众使徒，那一个晚上没有多马。
On another occasion, he appeared to the apostles without Thomas.
然后又一个晚上，众使徒还有多马也在内。
He appeared to seven disciples on the shores of the Sea of Galilee.
有一次，他显现给七个门徒在加利利的海边。
He appeared to the apostles on a mountain in Galilee.
也有一次，显现给众使徒在加利利一个山上。
He appeared to Cephas, then the 12, and then over 500 brethren.
然后又显现给基法，还有十二个门徒，最后五百个弟兄们。
He appeared to his brother James,
还有他的弟弟雅各。
To the apostles and ate a meal with them.
还有有一次显现给众使徒看，还与他们一同进食。
He appeared to Paul,
还有使徒保罗。
Since then, the multitude of people have come to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior.
自从他显现，许多人就来到主耶稣面前。
Millions of people around the world have come to know Jesus as their Lord and Savior.
成千上万的人从世界各地就知道耶稣是主，他们来相信他。
Researchers say that in China alone, over four decades, the Christian population has increased from 1 million to 100 million.
研究告诉我们，过去四十年，就算在中国，本来只有100万基督徒，现在有4000万。
100 million.
从来本来是100万，现在是一中文的1亿了。
Yes, friends, we have a Savior who died and rose again.
朋友们，我们所相信的救主，他从死里已经复活了。
But that's not the end of the story.
但是这个不是结局。
The Bible tells us that Jesus is coming again.
圣经告诉我们，耶稣将要再来。
In John chapter 14, verses 2 to 3, we read, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also.
约翰福音第十四章第二到三节说，在我父的家里有许多的住处，若是没有，我就早已告诉你们了。我去原是为你们预备地方去，我越去为你们预备了地方，就必再来接你们到我那里来，那里去。我在哪里，你叫你们也在哪里。
In Revelation chapter 22, verse 12, Jesus says, Behold, I come quickly.
在启示录第二十二章第十二节，主耶稣清楚地说：“看啊，我必快来。”
Some 6 or 7 years ago, I was preaching here, And some of you might remember the story that I mentioned about a new preacher.
大概六七年前，弟兄也在这里传道，你们可能记得一个故事。
The story is told of this new preacher fresh from college who was preaching on the second coming of Christ.
这个故事是说一个新毕从神学院毕业的传道人，他要来传道，传道关乎主耶稣要再来。
Suddenly, his mind went blank.
突然间他脑袋空白了，什么都忘记了。
He forgot what follows.What he had said.
他不知道下一句应该继续讲什么。
Whilst he was in college, he was taught that if any time you have a memory lapse while preaching, just repeat the last sentence you said, and that will help to jolt your memory.
然后他就记得神学院学到，如果有时候你突然间忘记讲什么的话，你就重复你最后一句说话话。
His last words were, "Behold, I come quickly." From Revelation 22:12.
他就记得他刚刚说完的就是启示录22:12说到，我必快来。
So he repeated this phrase, and nothing came to his mind.
所以他就重复这一句，我必快来，但是好像还记不得要说什么。
Again repeated loudly for the second time, "Behold, I come quickly."
所以他大声地再说，重复说，看啊，我必快来。
And still nothing happened.
还没有事情发生。
This time he was getting a bit flustered, and he banged the pulpit with all his might and said, "Behold, I come quickly for the third time."
所以第三次他很激动。而且拍在讲台上面说，第三句很大声地说，我必快来。
Unfortunately, the old pulpit on which he was standing broke, and he fell onto the lap of an old lady who was sitting right in front of the pew.
很可惜的，那个旧的讲台都给他打破了，突然他的整个垮下去，扑倒在一个老的姐妹面前。
He was so embarrassed.He apologized to the lady and said, "Sorry, dear, I did not mean to do it."
当然，他很觉得很羞愧，都马上向这位姐妹说道歉。对不起，我不是要打扰你的。
The lady turned around, looked him at his face, and said, "You need not to say sorry, Pastor, because you warned me 3 times that you were coming."
但是这个姐妹说，其实也不用道歉了，因为其实我应该离开的。你已经警告过我3次，说我要来了。
Friends, Jesus is indeed coming again, and we have been warned more than 3 times in the Bible that He is coming back.
朋友们，其实耶稣必要将来，我们听过不止3次，圣经多次的告诉我们说，耶稣说我要再来。
In the Old Testament, the return of Christ is emphasized in no less than 17 books, and the New Testament authors speak of it in 23 out of 27 books.
整本圣经里面，旧约17本里面，新约的23本都说到主要再来。
One out of every 30 verses in the New Testament teaches us that Christ is coming back to this earth.
每30节新约圣经里面，你就找到一节，主耶稣说：“我要回到这个世界。”
Jesus himself referred to his return 21 times in the Bible.
耶稣自己说了21篇，说到我要回来。
The fact that the second coming of Christ is featured so prominently in the scripture indicates that this event is important to God, and as a result, it should be important to all of us.
既然那么清楚地告诉我们那么多遍，我们就知道这个是非常重要的事情，对神，对我们也是。
When Jesus comes, the dead in Christ will be raised to newness of life.
当主耶稣回来的时候，在基督里死来的死亡的人要复活，得着新的生命。
And those who are alive and know Christ as their personal Lord and Savior will be caught up with him to live and reign with him.
那是还没死活在地上的哈，就给主借到天上，与主永远同活。
What does the resurrection of Christ mean for us today?
但是我们要问基督的复活今天的意义何在？
Firstly, Jesus' resurrection guarantees our own future resurrection.
第一，耶稣的复活保证我们将来也必复活。
In other words, we are going to receive a resurrected, glorious, and perfect body.
就是说，我们也会接受到一个荣耀复活的身体。
In 1 Corinthians 15:20-22, we read, "But Christ has indeed been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since death came through a man, the resurrection of the dead comes also through a man. For as in Adam all die, so in Christ all will be made alive."
哥林多前书第十五章二十到二十二节，但基督已经从死里复活，成了睡了之人初熟的果子。死既是因一人而来，死人复活也是因一人而来。在亚当里，众人都死了。照样在基督里，众人也都要复活。
Secondly, Jesus' resurrection guarantees our potential to live a victorious and overcoming life in this world.
第二，耶稣基督的复活也保证我们有力量活出得胜者的生活。
We live in a world that is riddled with diseases, wars, starvation. And in the face of this crisis and uncertainties that it brings, we need a life that can overcome and rise above these uncertainties.
今天我们活在这个世界是充满疾病、打仗、饥荒，很多很多不平凡、没有稳定的事情都要发生。我们需要有一个生命，帮助我们能够成为一个得胜者，在这些患难的事情遭遇上面。我们能够得胜有余。
Is there such a life?
但是也有可能吗？
The good news is there is.
感谢主，答案是有可能。
The Bible clearly teaches us that this life could only be found in Christ our Lord.
圣经告诉我们，只有在耶稣基督里，我们才能有这个得胜的生命。
In other words, it is only our Lord Jesus Christ who can give us or guarantee us that kind of life.
也只有从耶稣基督那里，我们才有这个保证，得着这个生命。
It is a life that appropriates Christ's resurrection power.
因为我们得的生命，就是耶稣基督复活的生命。
The Apostle Paul experienced and knew this life.
使徒保罗清楚也知道这个复活的生命是什么。
And that's why he was able to pray for the Ephesians believers in Ephesians 1:18-21.
所以他能够从在以弗所书里面告诉门徒这个复活的生命是什么。
Where he says, "I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened, in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people." And his incomparable great power for us who believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly realms. For above all rule and authority, power and dominion, and every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the age to come.
以弗所书第一章第十八到二十一节，保罗说，并且照明你们心中的眼睛，使你们知道他的恩召有何等指望，他在圣徒中得的基业有何等丰盛的荣耀，并知道他向我们这信的人所显的能力是何等浩大，就是叫他在基督身上所运行的大能大力， 使他从死里复活，叫他在天上坐在自己右边，远超过一切执政的、掌权的、有能的、主祭的和一切有名的，不但是近世的，连来世的也都超过了。
Paul mentions three important things.
保罗这里说到三样很重要的事情。
That the believers at Ephesus already have because of their faith and relationship with Christ.
保罗告诉说明以弗所教会的信徒有三样已拥有的，因为他们在耶稣基督里面的信。
Firstly, a blessed and unfailing hope of their calling.
首先是一个有福并且永不希望的护照。
Secondly, the indestructible wealth or treasure of their inheritance in Christ.
第二，在基督里丰富并且永不衰残的财产。
And thirdly, an unlimited power that is available and working in their lives as believers of Christ.
第三，就是一个无限的能力帮助信徒活出基督的生命。
According to Paul, this power is the power that raised Jesus from the dead and is now working and available to us as believers.
根据保罗，这个能力什么能力？这个能力就是耶稣怎么样从死里复活，今天这个能力也活在我们每一个信徒里面。
This power comes from the Holy Spirit who resides with us as his children.
这个能力是从圣灵居在圣徒心里面的能力出来。
We appropriate this power by faith in Jesus.
如果我们相信耶稣，我们也能得着这个能力。
If the Lord's resurrection power is available and working in and for us today, then it means that by faith in Jesus, we can have victory over sin and temptation.
如果主的复活能力是真实而且能够应用在我们身上的话，就证明第一，我们有胜过罪和试探的能力。
Secondly, we can now have victory over our strongholds or bondages in our life.
第二，我们也有能力胜过一直纠缠在我们身上的捆锁。
Thirdly, we can now have victory over trials and crises of life that confront us.
我们第三也有能力能胜过我们面对许多的困难、许多的试炼、许多的危机。
Although the death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ happened 2,000 years ago, its effects and blessings is still ongoing today.
虽然耶稣基督从肉身复活已经发生2000年以前，但是他的能力、他的现实，现在我们也能经历。
If there is someone here this morning that does not know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, let me tell you, that this risen Christ, who we have been talking about this morning, is able and willing to offer you forgiveness of sin.
在我们当中，今天如果还有人还没相信主耶稣的话，让我告诉你，这个福音就是为着你们，他能够赦免你的罪。
He is able to offer you fellowship with God.
不止这样，他也能够把你跟神重新和好。
He is able to offer you eternal life.
这个福音要给你一个永远的生命。
He is able to offer you a family relationship with God, that of sons and daughters of the living God.
他呀，把一个重新的关系，就是好像父母跟子女一样，你和神重新的建立关系。
He is able to offer you peace.
这个福音要给你真正的平安。
To accept this offer, you must firstly acknowledge that you are a sinner.
当然，如果你要接受的话，第一，你要承认你是一个罪人。
The Bible tells us in Romans 3:23, "For all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God."
圣经罗马书第三章二十三节告诉我们，世人都犯了罪，亏欠了神的荣耀。
Secondly, the penalty for sin is death.
第二就是 罪的工价就是死。
Romans 6:23 says the wages of sin is death.
罗马书第六章二十三节告诉我们，罪的工价就是死。
Thirdly, God has paid the penalty for your sin when He sent His only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, to die for you on the cross.
第三，神已经为着我们的罪，他把他的独生爱子差遣到世界来，承担我们的罪债。死在十字架上。
He died taking your sin and mine on his own body on the cruel cross.
当他被很残酷的钉死在十字架上的时候，其实他是帮你把我们的罪都一同钉死。
Fourthly, on the third day, he rose victorious from the grave, as we have considered this morning.
但是第三天，他从死里复活了，就是今天我们。刚刚所传的
and is inviting you to come to him for forgiveness and eternal life.
他今天就邀请你来到他那里，接受这个罪得赦免、得永生的福音。
The second part of Romans 6:23 says, "But the gift of God is eternal life."
罗马书第六章第二十三节背后的说，但是神的恩赐就是永生。
Will you come to him and accept his offer of forgiveness and eternal life today?
朋友们，你是否愿意来到耶稣面前，来接受他送给你的一个赦罪得永生的礼物？
Let's bow our heads in a word of prayer.
让我们低头祷告。
Let's spend a few moments in silent prayer as we consider what God has done for us in giving His only begotten Son as our ransom on Calvary's cross.
我们有一点安静的时间来思想神如何差遣他的爱子死在十字架上为我们。
If there's anyone here who does not know Jesus and would like to accept Him as your personal Lord and Savior, you could do so this morning.
如果今天有人你还没接受主耶稣成为你的救主，你今天早上就可以做这个决定。
If the Lord is speaking to you, don't put it off.
如果主耶稣已经向你说话，你就不要拒绝。
You may be a Christian and you wandered away from Him.
你可能已经是基督徒，但是你离开主很久了。
You can come back to Him and rededicate your life to Him.
你可以重新回到主那里，重新把你的生命交给主。
His risen power is available for you today.
他复活的能力，今天你也能够接受。
If there's anyone who likes to accept Jesus as your Savior or come back and rededicate your life to Him, please just raise your hands so that we can pray for you.
如果我们当中有人愿意接受主耶稣，或者你愿意重新回到主耶稣那里，请你举起手，我们为你祷告。
Anyone likes to accept Jesus as your Savior, just raise your hands and put it down again.
请问有没有人愿意接受主耶稣，重新交给主耶稣？请你轻轻举手，我们为你祷告。
Praise the Lord.
谢谢主，感谢主。
Anyone else before we go to prayer?
还有没有人呢？我们要为你祷告。感谢主。
Anyone else for the last time? And we're going to.
最后我再问，有没有人愿意接受主耶稣，或者你愿意重新把你的生命交给主耶稣？请你举起手，我们为你祷告。
Thank you.
感谢主。
Let's pray.
让我们一同祷告。
Eternal God, our loving Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day that we can celebrate with all your children throughout the world.
亲爱的神，永远活着的父，我们感谢主，今天我们能够和众圣徒一同来庆祝这个荣耀的事实。
The resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead.
就是耶稣基督从死里复活了。
We thank you for the instances recorded in the Bible where our risen Lord personally appeared to so many people.
我们感谢主，圣经很清楚地告诉我们，主耶稣你亲自地 复活后显现给许多的人看。
After you raised him from the grave on the third day.
当你第三天复活以后，你就显现。
We thank you for opening the eyes of all those who set out to prove that the resurrection was a myth.
感谢主，开了许多人本来是不信的，本来要反对他们的眼睛。
And bringing them to faith in you.
最后把信送给他们，他们都知道是真实的。
We thank you for the millions of people around the world who have had a personal encounter with our risen Lord and Savior.
我感谢赞美主，整个世界上面成千千上万的人都经历过耶稣的真实。
We want to specially pray for those in our midst who do not know you as their personal Lord and Savior.
我特别为我们在当门当中还有人没有接受你成为救主的人祷告。
Please continue to work in them, dear Lord, and give them no peace till they come and find that peace in you.
求你继续的在他们生命工作，不让他们安静，直到他们找到在你里面真的平安。
We thank you for your brother here who has indicated that he would like to accept you as his Lord and Savior.
我为着刚才举手愿意接受的，为他们感谢主。
Bless him, Lord, and make yourself real to him.
求你祝福他们，让你的真实很清楚地在他们生命中显明。
That he will grow in faith and be an instrument in bringing others to faith in you.
让他们能够在心里面长进，而且其他人周边的人也看见他们的改变。
For those of us who already know you as our Lord and Savior, Lord,
就像我们当中已经相信你，知道你是我们的救主的人。
We thank you for the assurance that the power that raised Jesus from the dead is available to us.
谢谢你，你告诉我们，耶稣基督从死里复活的这个能力，今天我们也能经历。
And by faith in Jesus, we can have victory over sin and temptation.
在耶稣里的信心，我们就能够得胜有余，在罪恶、在试探上面。
We can have victory over our bondages in life.
我们能够对一直捆绑我们的问题，我们得胜。
We can have victory over our trials and the crises that confront us in our life.
许多的试炼，许多的危机要打倒我们，但是我们在你里面能得胜。
May each one of us catch a fresh glimpse of our resurrected Lord and Savior.
求你让我们每一个人重新的知道明白你的复活对我们的影响。
And the agape love that was demonstrated at Calvary's cross, and which will spur us into service for you.
你可在十字架上显明 agape 的爱，重新的激励我们来爱你，跟随你。
We ask all these things in the worthy and precious name of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
我们今天的祷告是奉主耶稣基督得胜复活的名祷告。
Amen.
Praise the Lord for this wonderful message that was spoken this morning.
感谢主早上给我们那么美好的信息。
We'd like to thank the Lord for once again in this very challenging time.
我们感谢主在这个充满挑战的时候。
When there's a lot of experience that we are going through, that we are facing.
我们经过不平凡的时候。
And today, the message I hope this morning, the word of God will touch us.
我希望今天早上的信息对每一位都是有帮助的。
And will again remind us of our
salvation. 也提醒我们，我们得救了。
As I was coming to this, reflecting on what the message was spoken this morning.
当我一面听一面思想今天的早上的信息的时候
，Immediately there is a song that I'd like to share with you all before we end this meeting.
我希望跟大家分享一首的诗歌。
It's from our main hymn book 114.
在我们大本的诗歌114首。
As we reflect on this song, I'd like to ask that you all sort of be reflecting in the time of this celebration that the world is going through with the, as we know that this is an Easter celebration.
普世都在庆祝复活的时候，我们一同唱这首歌。
And we call it celebration.
我们需要庆祝。
And there's a reason why we celebrate.
因为有原因的。
And for those who still do not understand this, this celebration,
如果你还不明白为什么我们要庆祝呢？
We pray that the Lord will, our God will, touch you this morning.
我求主的感动你的心。
And firstly, 114.
114.
I'd like to go through with you the it's a very short hymn, but I think it will give you a very good time for our reflection.
很短的一首歌，但对我们来欣赏很有帮助。
Can we ask everyone to, maybe let's read through the song.
我们一同来读好吗
？Before we sing.
因他活着，我能面对明天。因他活着。
不再惧怕，我深知道他掌管明天，生命充满了希望，只因他活着。
So let's reflect as we sing this song.
好，我们一面唱的时候，一面思想内容。
And because I know that he holds the future.
他掌管明天。
And one of the words that reflected very much strongly in this morning's message.
今天早上的信息一直在说这个。
And life is worth the living.
生命能够充满希望，有价值。
And that is the hope God has given us.
这个是神给我们的盼望。
And especially in this challenging time that we are all facing.
好，在这段时间。
We can reflect on this hymn.
盼望这首歌成为你的帮助。
And he has given us hope.
他给我们希望。
And we thank our Lord Jesus that he has given his life for us.
感谢主，他为我们牺牲舍命。
And he's he's broken his body and shed his blood for us.
他的身体为我们挂在木头上。
And with his resurrection,
他复活了。
He has given us hope.
他的复活给我们希望。
Okay, especially like to share this very much with you, those who still do not know the Lord, that.We can together sing this hymn.
还没有信主的，我特别邀请你跟我们一同来唱。
Friends, they are here with us this morning.
我们特别欢迎第一次来到我们当中的朋友或者
兄弟姐妹。And call your name if you can stand up, that we would like to welcome you.
读你的名字的时候，请你站起来。徐其明，徐其明，
弟兄，
欢迎，
欢迎你，
欢迎你。
还有
Christine Chan，Christine， 欢迎 Christine，
welcome。
还有他的儿子。一对夫妇，徐旭、张满英，好，欢迎你们，欢迎，
欢迎你们啊！
还有 Alan Low 夫妇 ，Alan 和 Ada， 欢迎欢迎。
We thank you all for able to have this time together in this wonderful.Sharing.
特别高兴复活节的时候，你们跟我们一道
And I also invite you all that after this, we have lunch together.
也邀请你们跟我们吃中饭。
Okay, then we have more fellowship with one another.
能够更多的认识。
Okay, and there's no other announcement. Okay.
好。
Okay, shall we give thanks to the to our lunch?
好，我们为中饭祷告。
Dear Heavenly Father, we do thank you for your grace and your love.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢你给我们的恩典和慈爱。
And you have given us our love, your begotten Son, our love, and wonderful Savior, our Lord Jesus Christ.
更感谢你，你把你的爱子赐给我们，成为我们的救主。
And to die on the cross for us and to redeem us for our sins.
他为我们被钉死在十字架上，把我们从罪中拯救出来。
And you have given us hope in our life.
你给我们希望。
And we, Lord, we thank you for this morning, the message that once again you have given to us.
我们感谢你早上的信息对我们说话。
And for this, Lord, we give glory to you.
我们把荣耀归给你。
May all glory and honor be upon you.
所有的荣耀尊贵都是你的。
And Lord, we also thank you for the time of our given. Bless us with this time of our fellowship together.
我们感谢主，让我们能够遇到彼此有交通。
May you bless the lunch time.
求你祝福午饭的时候。
And also the hands that prepared that for us.
祝福预备午餐的弟兄姐妹。
And bless this time for us together that we can continue to share the love that you have given us.
求你祝福叫你的儿女能够依从在你的爱中彼此的相交。
And may all glory and honor be upon you.
所有的荣耀都归给你。
We pray all this in the precious name of our Lord Jesus.
我们将祷告奉主耶稣宝贝的名。
Amen.
Amen.